Going up to the Sita. Going up towards the waterfall. Come on out. We're going to probably do a little bit more, and then we'll probably come back. It's good, isn't it?
Get a bit wet.
Hey. Sea shower. Sea shower. Seven sisters in front of us. Mountain farms. Let's see what we can see here.
It's a farm up inside in the mountain. Okay. Or a house.
Mm. can't see any. Colour's doing brilliant. Yeah. Oh, thank you.
I see up there is called Knives Floor, and they sat down in 1818, but you could even further back in that, so like they had a lot of animals and a lot of children, and to keep track of all the children they had, they used to tie rope around them, tie them to the wall, so they would not fall down and they would die. The rope keeps them down. And they had as much as 100 boats and 15 houses there. They also had a smaller house even further up the mountain that they called Sapas, and that's where they used to stay to get in care of the animals, because they used to stay further up the mountain to get their nutrients.
How did they actually get them?
It's a birch over there. It's a stone, a small where they used to hike up and down, and it takes approximately 30 to 50 minutes, depends a bit on your conditions. And but the family who used to live there had to move in 1889 because the government told them it was too dangerous, because the wall you see behind where it's supposed to fall down and crush the farm. So they were offered some land in Geiranger, but they didn't have any buildings there, so they brought down one of the buildings up there with a wire or a cable and transported over to Geiranger. But they still used the land, so they used to go back and forth to get the nutrients for the animals they had.
Imagine moving up there then. Probably.
Can you see
everything? I'm not sure. Still got plenty of time. So.
And the closest neighbor to Knivs flå was the Skagflå people. They used to live up there.
Ah, that little...
Yeah.
Ah, yeah.
And back in the days, it used to come a tax collector with his boat and park over there and hike it up. And when the farmer saw the tax collector, he just pulled the ladder and it was impossible.
Good idea.
Yeah. So it was the old method for tax fraud. So the road up now is much better than it used to be, so you don't actually need to climb. Today, maybe I'll go on. So it's also possible to hike up. It takes approximately 50 minutes, 20, 30, depends a bit. And it's also possible to hike over the mountain over to Geiranger. I'm not sure, but I haven't done it yet. So maybe in the future. They also have horses up there.
Thank you. There's a face up there.
Yeah. There's the troll.
Ah.
And a lot of people also say it looks a lot like Trump.
Yeah, exactly.
Just without the nose.
It's
here turns yellow in the end of summer. So over there you can see the start of the Eagle Road. And that's a road that they built the eagle for. They built the road up on an eagle nest. So it would be allowed today. And if you go even further in, you get to Geiranger. It takes approximately like 50 minutes from there to Geiranger. And over there we have the big Gjalla. Back in the days, it used to live out a woman over there. And she used to brew beer to all the farms around the area, and in exchange she used to get the water supplies that she needed for living there. But she was a bit unlucky, so her farm was crushed. Based on humla beer. So this is the cable that they use for transportation. They also use to bring down the house. And the house you saw over there is where they used to store their fishing equipment, so they would go up and down with it every time that they used it.
It's decent smell, yeah. Ha ha!
So this farm is called Matrika, or the food bank, and it was called one of the sunniest places in Geirangerfjord, and they were also able to grow potatoes and tomatoes and apricots. And they had a lot of animals, but they had to stop the farm because they used to pull a boat around here to get them supply, but when they built the road up there, you see, they had to leave the farm because it was impossible for them to continue.
How long ago was that?
They stopped in 1961. So the farm up there is the still operating farm. In the fjord is where our talking about the mountain that was going to fall. It's just a bit further in the fjord to the right.
How you doing? Yaffe? Yaffe? It's fun, isn't it? Go. Hey.